Hello there, God bless you. You are welcome to Prophetic Intercession with Amel. It's always a great pleasure for me to come your way with prophetic messages from the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless all our first timers and thank you so much for stopping by. Thank you for clicking on this video. I always say it is not a coincidence. If God led you here, He sure does have an agenda. He sure does have a plan for you. And I pray that you are going to stick around long enough to hear what God has for you on this platform. Hallelujah. And to all my returning subscribers, you already know how much you mean to me. You are so important to me. That is why each time when I am even doing my personal Bible studies, I am always trusting God for a specific word, because I know that someone is waiting to hear what God is saying. And I try to put myself in that position where I'll get to hear a word for you and share it, so that it will edify you, redirect you, confirm His words to you. God bless you. Thank you so much. If this is your first time and you've not touched that subscribe button, please go ahead and do that right now. And do not forget to turn on your notification bell. And if this word is edifying to you, if this word ministers to you, you can share it with someone you think needs to hear this. God bless you. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah. The Lord gave me this word. He says, someone saw you and they can't believe their eyes. They saw you, they can't believe their eyes, and right now they are ready for you. When the Lord dropped this word in my spirit, just one thing came to my mind. You know, when people bury you, they think it is the end of you. When people trample upon you, they think it is the end. But what they don't know is that we are seeds. When we are buried, we sprout and we grow like never before. That is who we are. When people try to destroy us, all they have to do is just let us be. It is just a matter of time before we are going to sprout up. It's just a matter of time before we are going to grow. We are going to germinate from where they thought they had, you know, dealt with us massively. Each time such prophetic words come to my spirit, I only think about one person. You know, I have used this character in the Bible like 1 million times, because, you know, his story, you can learn 1,000, you know, you can have 1,000 messages from his story. From what happened to him, you can have 1,000 revelations and 1,000 stories. Look at Joseph. His brothers thought they had killed him, or selling him to Egypt was a way of getting rid of him. It was another form of killing, because they were certain they were never going to meet him again. But guess what God did? When they met him, they did not meet him like the slave boy. They met him like a prime minister. And I mean, he was in a place of authority. They had no choice but to bow. And in this point, they were ready to do his bidding, whatsoever he decided. He said, go and bring my parents, bring everyone over to the land of Egypt. They could not even object it, because he was the man in charge. He was the man in command. The same person they felt like they had killed, they had buried, he was the one in charge. God is laying it in my spirit to talk to someone. You are in a situation right now. You are in a condition. People are laughing at you because they feel like you have given your heart to Christ. They think you're frustrated. They think you don't know what to do with your life. They feel like, you know, you can do better than serve God the way you do. You can do better than love on God the way you do. They make a mockery of your Christianity. And they say, I mean, you don't know what you're doing. Believe me, child of God. It's just a matter of time. You see this God, they are making a mockery of you, because you see this God, they are laughing at you for his sake. A time is coming when God will lift you, when God will elevate you. And the same people that used to laugh at you, they will come to you to ask, what is your secret? The people who used to who used to say you are frustrated, who used to say you have lost it, they will come to you to ask you, what is your secret? What did you do? How did you do it? You know, I had a personal testimony I wanted to share, but excuse me, I feel like it's not time, so I'm going to share another person's testimony. There is this person I know, beautiful, anointed, but for a while, when she just gave her heart to Christ, everybody gave up on her, her parents, everyone. She was very brilliant and excuse me, very brilliant, and her parents really believed so much that she was going to, become someone really influential and everything. And her giving her life to Christ was like dashing all their hopes. Like, that's not what they expected of her. And they made a mockery of her God, they made a mockery of her Christianity. Thank God she did not give up. She kept on pressing on. She kept on pressing on. And over the years, God started shining his light upon her. The light of God was so great, or has been so great upon her. Now, this person did not only receive persecution from family, but even from friends, people who knew her, they were like, what are you doing? You can do better with your life than waste it to church, waste it to God. You can do better, because it didn't seem like God was doing much. It didn't seem like God was blessing her much back then. So, but guess what? When God started blessing, when the light of God started shining in her life, the people who used to laugh, it started from her family. They started coming to her like, lead us to God. Help us know God better. Pray for us. When they have an issue, they'll call her, pray for us. When they have financial challenges, they're going to call her, support us. And even the people around her, friends and family that thought she had lost it, they started coming to her like, tell us, what is the secret? How are you serving God that he's blessing you so much? Now they were ready to hear the gospel. They were ready to listen, because God had showed himself strong in her life. The light of God had shone upon her so greatly. And God is telling me to encourage someone. Right now, things do not seem like they are working well, and there's so much pressure coming. A lot of pressure is coming, and you feel like you should just abandon and go and seek your life out there. But even if only you can hang on, a day is coming when God will start shining his light upon you, that these people that have criticized you and laughed and mocked at your God, they would come to you to ask you, what did you do? How did you do it? Please show us. And then you're going to lead them to Christ. That will be your story of how you transform and won them over. Hallelujah. Child of God, hang in there. That day is coming sooner than later, believe me.